I'm KJ. I teach rope, kazami style rope, at the Toronto Kinbaku Salon.
And I'm Lilly. I'm his partner.
And rope bottom.
I'm also his rope bottom. I self-tie. I tie other people.
So my first experience with Shibari was around 15 years ago. I saw, in my late teens, a picture of a girl bound up, and it just clicked right away that this was something amazing. I came to the Toronto Kinbaku Salon and I started learning rope. I think the focus, for me at least, and for many people who practice of Shibari has developed, is really connection with your partner. And so whether that's sexual or erotic, or simply aesthetic, or even fun, or silly or spiritual, it's really up to the people involved.
I find that you get a lot out of the little nuances and just like connecting with another person and seeing their reactions and how they interact with you and what you're doing. And that like immediate feedback is really, really fulfilling.
I think with Shibari, it's not really a work, it's a passion. And so I do have a vanilla day job, but I would say that to do Shibari is like someone who is a skilled craftsperson. You know, there's people who will spend 20 years or 30 years learning a craft to become a master at that craft. And Shibari is something like that. I still feel like I'm fairly new to it, and that there's a lifetime of learning and seeking and growing in this.
It looks sort of scary or painful. Well, truthfully, it is painful. But it's painful in a very similar way to jumping into an extremely hot tub, and then you can sort of settle into it over time. It's still hot, but you get used to it. So usually when you're suspended in rope, as you go through the different transitions, you sort of get a bit of an endorphin high through that. So it's just like pain, relief, pain, relief, pain, relief. And as the endorphin high builds up, then eventually when you come down, you can be a little bit spacey.
It's really important to have some aftercare and really just that moment of connection and like losing yourself in the experience of it. And you know, with my partner, I know that, you know, when we come out of rope, we enjoy having that time to come down out of that space together.
Important thing is to have fun with it, because if you get too bogged down in all the technical details, except for safety, safety is important, but if you get too bogged down in the technical details, it can sometimes be overwhelming. So just keep in mind, it's fun.
My passion for it is just growing. It's really something that has enriched my life. And actually, we found each other through rope, and we live together, and she's my love. Thanks.